Hello and welcome to FieldWire. Configuring tasks is critical to establishing a clear workflow that will streamline your project's processes. In this video, we will review how to configure tasks by customizing categories, statuses, and attributes to meet your team's project needs. After determining the correct configuration for tasks, you can use the same settings on future projects with the Project Cloning feature, making it easy to get your next project started. The clone feature helps expedite and templatize project creation by copying over features from any existing project to a new one. From the FieldWire project launch page, select the plus new project button. After naming your new project, choose an existing project to clone the categories, statuses, attributes, and more from the click of a button. Make sure the correct boxes are selected after choosing a project in order to copy them into a new project. Of course, all of these features can be revised or deleted even after creating the project. To kick things off, let's start with configuring categories. Categories are simply the easiest way your team would like to organize tasks into different subgroups. Imagine if your project has 1,000 tasks. Categories allow your team to easily narrow them down to manage or report on them. Categories can be created in a few different ways. As an example, general contractors often define categories by the various trades on the construction project. They may include drywall, electrical, mechanical, and plumbing. For subcontractors, categories are often defined as the scopes of work that your team manages on a job site. Examples for an electrical subcontractor may include QAQC inspections, GC constraints, and rough-in. If you are a low-voltage sub, you might use categories for the components of the work you install, like interior or exterior cameras, wireless access points, door contacts, cabling, etc. Project admins can create, edit, or delete categories in the left-hand toolbar under the Plans or Task module. To create categories to your project, select the Plus New Category option at the bottom of the categories list. Your categories will sort alphanumerically. To reorder the list, add a number to the beginning of the category name, for example, 1, Safety, 2, Housekeeping, 3, Punch. Select the gear icon to the right of the category to edit or delete them as necessary. The two-character code for each category will be shown on your task pins and can be edited here as well. You can also add categories directly from a task. As a project admin, open or create a task. Within the Task Attributes column on the right-hand side, select Categories. From here, you can scroll to the bottom of the list and select Plus New Category. After adding it, remember to click the blue checkbox to ensure it is added properly. Next, let's talk about configuring custom task statuses. Statuses are the headers of the columns in the Task Kanban view. They allow you to mirror your current workflow processes through names, colors, permissions, and their order. Depending on how your team chooses to define its task statuses, they can be used to signify a task's priority level, phase of work, or the process in which a task is involved with. Example priority levels may be low, medium, and high priority. Example phases are rough-in, cable terminated, and testing. Process examples can include constraints, inspections, punch list, or QAQC. Project admins can access the Manage Status module through the Settings tab or the Kanban view. In the Kanban view, select the gear icon at the top of the status column. The Manage Status module will pop up, showing the current statuses on your project. Here you can alter their name, color, type, permission, and order. You can also add new ones by selecting the plus new status button, or you can delete one altogether by selecting the trash icon. When deleting a task status, all tasks within it will automatically move to the default status. Therefore, we recommend that you batch edit tasks within the status you're deleting into a preferred status prior to deletion. FieldWire has three different status types: open, tracked, and verified. Both tracked and verified statuses record the date a task was moved into it, so dates can be analyzed through task filters, reports, and graphs. While there can be several open and tracked statuses, you can only have a single verified status. Verified tasks will be archived after a set period of time determined under the Settings tab. However, you can limit the access to certain statuses by editing their permissions. You can adjust the status such that it can be used by all users, admins and members, or admins only. One key thing to note is that custom task statuses will follow an open to track to verified workflow. In other words, a verified status cannot come before a tracked status, and a tracked status cannot come before an open status. Use the arrow options to adjust the order of the task statuses. You will need a minimum of 3, but can have a total maximum of 7. Let's say my foreman has just moved this paint task to completed because he finished painting the north wall. Now my architect wants me to repaint it. I can move the paint task from the tracked completed status to the open rework status. Therefore, tasks do not have to follow a linear workflow, but the status columns will follow the open, tracked, to verified workflow from left to right. The next step in the task configuration process is to customize your task attributes. By default, FieldWire includes attributes for all tasks that are created, but business tier users can create custom task attributes. Custom task attributes, or CTAs, allow project admins to customize the fields on a task to allow the team to collect specific data on a project. Project admins can access the Manage Task Attributes window from the Task section of the Settings tab or within an individual task by selecting the gear icon that appears when you hover next to the Task Attributes text. From this pop-up, you can view and manage the list of the current task attributes that are available for data input across all of the tasks on a given project. The default task attributes are status, category, assignee, plan, location, start date, end date, manpower, cost, tags, and watchers. To create CTAs, select Add Custom Attribute. From here, you can select the attribute type and name it. The types are short text, number, and list. Short text attributes allow users to input free-form text, symbols, or numbers. Number attributes only allow users to input decimals or integers. List attributes provide a drop-down that users can select from. You can use an existing list for this type of CTA or create a new one from here by selecting plus custom list. You are prompted to enter an attribute name, which then becomes the name of the CTA. Create your list by copy-pasting from a spreadsheet or by entering it manually in the pop-up. From the Manage Task Attributes window, use the arrows to rearrange the order of how the attributes show up in a task. You can also choose to toggle off the plan, location, manpower, cost, tags, and any custom attributes if these are not wanted. Keep in mind that by hiding any attributes, you are effectively hiding the associated data as well. However, the attribute data is not deleted, so by simply re-enabling these attributes, you will be able to view the data again. Now that you have configured your task categories, statuses, and attributes, you are able to filter for them in the Task Kanban, Calendar, Gantt or Analytics views, and include the data in your task reports. For more detailed information on configuring tasks, please check out our help article linked in the description box below. If you have any questions, please contact us at support@fieldwire.com.